vaccinate the world. The foundation has been sued by the governments of some of the poorest and most vulnerable nations for causing serious harm through experimental vaccine programs.
If you just look at healthcare workers around the world, they deserve to get the vaccine first. You know, here in the United States, really, it's going to be Black people who really should get it first, and many Indigenous people.
Vaccines were always taught to us that it was safe, it was healthy, this is things that we had to do. But given the position that I am in now as a state legislator, and looking at these studies and reviewing a lot of these studies, it's very scary. And I want the African American community to open up their eyes.
Of all the places that Mr. Gates could have gone in the world, why did he settle on Africa? It's not because he cares about people that look like me. He cares about an agenda.
African bodies have been used as lab rats for many years for Big Pharma.
They are using us for trials, they are using us for testing, but as an African, I say no more.
Africans, they're tired of becoming the guinea pigs of the world. Their antennas are raised and they're telling each other all over social media. They're on high alert right now.
There is a policy of the American government. It's called the Kissinger Report, which was produced in the mid-70s. And it explicitly states that the purpose of the foreign policy in Africa was to reduce the population, because they have great mineral resources there. At the time, Kissinger and those involved with the Carter administration wanted to shrink the population, make sure that the Africans do not develop and do not use the resources for themselves, because we in the States, we need them. There is a concerted effort of foreign powers to control the population of Africa.
Some children did survive the botched vaccinations last month and will recover, but 15, all under the age of 5, died from fever, vomiting, and diarrhea.
Human errors contributed to the unfortunate deaths of the children.
How can you believe Big Pharma but not believe these parents when they tell you that their children have been injured by Big Pharma? I don't care how big this corporate machine looks. As a parent, I can tell you, these people will never stop fighting for their kids.
And a lot of them are Hamites, but it just goes to show you that this devil will not stop. And it shows you that he is not your friend. For all of you Israelites out there, the ones of you who are pro-Trump, pro-America, how many times have Trump mentioned about this agenda that Bill Gates and them are trying to do? And why isn't he speaking up to stop it, since he cares so much about you? He cares so much about the so-called Black community. Where's the UN? Where is Russia? Where is any other power or legislative saying that enough is enough? We are not going to use the people of Africa as guinea pigs anymore. For all of you guys who love America and you're pro-Trump, when's the last time he said anything about this? It's clear what they're doing. You see exactly what she's saying, but where's the outrage on the White House? It's not happening, right? It's because they're all on point with this. And the Lord has had enough of you Edomites, you devils. 2 Ezra chapter 11, verse 40. And the fourth came and overcame all the beasts that were past, and had power over the world with great fearfulness, and over the whole compass of the earth with much wicked oppression. And so long time dwelt he upon the earth with deceit. For the earth hast thou not judged with truth. For thou hast afflicted the meek. Thou hast hurt the peaceable. Thou hast loved liars and destroyed the dwellings of them that brought forth fruit, and hast cast down walls of such as did thee no harm. Therefore is thy wrongful dealing come up unto the highest, and thy pride unto the mighty. The highest also have looked upon the proud times, and behold, they are ended, and his abominations are fulfilled, and therefore appear no more, thou eagle, nor thy horrible wings, nor thy wicked feathers, nor thy malicious heads, nor thy hurtful claws, nor all thy vain body. This is the vision that the prophets have received, going back to the book of Daniel. And in the end of the vision, they all had a similar ending, which was a roaring lion, or Yahawashah, destroying this place. Put an end to this man and his hurtful works and his hurtful deeds. Here we are in a quote-unquote pandemic or hard times, which this COVID-19 is all a hoax. It's just merely a ploy. We are in these hard times, and the devil does not lay off. He's letting you know that I'm going to still move forward with this. He's telling you straight up to your face, here's what I'm going to do, and I'm going to execute it. I'm going to go over there to Africa. I'm going to use your people as guinea pigs, because in the history, we've always been trying to kill you off by all kinds of means, including by bioweapon warfare, and vaccines is one of them. We have created a setting out of fear where we're going to force everybody to get the vaccine, and we're going to use you people to do it first because we know that we want to kill you off, and that's what we're doing this for. Where's the outrage? Why isn't President Trump saying anything? Because they are all your enemy, as the scripture says. A friend cannot be known in prosperity, and the enemy cannot be hid in adversity. We are in these quote-unquote hard times, and you are seeing who your enemy is. He's showing his horns. There's no denying it. And the thing is, our people are waking up to this. Even though there's no other power that's speaking up, that's why the scriptures tell you, Israelites, who will bemoan thee, O Israel? Who will go aside to ask how thou doest? Why isn't the UN stopping this? Let there be one small sovereign country so much as threaten the nation of Israel where the fake Jews dwell. You're going to hear the U.S. and the UN talk about using military force. But here you have an agenda to vaccinate and kill off all our people, yet no one's making a sound, of course, except our own people. That's to show you that you're still in slavery. But the Most High is about to put an end to this devil and his wicked deeds. Psalms chapter 12. For the oppression of the poor, for the sighing of the needy, now will I arise, saith the Lord. I will set him in safety from him that puffeth at him. So, quoting that scripture once more, this is why the Lord is raising up, because of the oppression of the poor and the sighing of the needy. You devils are trying to roll fast, but we have a power that's watching over us and that has us under his wing, that hopefully elect the elect. And you won't be able to touch us, Lord willing. I'm a part of that number. Whatever you try to do, just know what we have already overcome, and we will prevail. Truth will prevail. Read verse 45 once more. And therefore appear no more thou eagle, nor thy horrible wings, nor thy wicked feathers, nor thy malicious heads, nor thy hurtful claws, nor all thy vain body. This is why you Edomites, you belong in slavery, man. You're going into slavery. You would no more run this earth. I haven't even heard so much as the average citizen Edomite talk about how, yeah, they're just trying to vaccinate black. They're not even saying that. Nobody cares. Because everybody's just like, whatever the hell with them. All the earth may be refreshed and may return, being delivered from thy violence. You see, this whole world is waiting for your ass to go down. Did you know that? If you read Isaiah chapter 14, the animals and the trees, all of them are consciously waiting for you to go down. They are all pleading with the Lord, the Creator, the Father of all things, the Father of all spirits and creatures. How long, O Lord, will you allow this devil, this hewer, to trample on the earth? And as Yahweh promised the earth, because the earth was created for the Israelites' sake, it was created for Yahawashah's sake. This is his kingdom, and the earth was created for us, and you're destroying it. As the Lord said, until the time is sealed, that's when this devil's going to go down. It says, being delivered from thy violence, and that she may hope for the judgment and mercy of him that made her. Because the earth is waiting for the Lord to return. The earth is waiting for you devils to go down. You deceitful people. We know what you're doing. The world knows what you're doing. But just know that you are prophesied to go down. This is the last leg of the Roman Empire. You're at your end. The prophets have already envisioned you trying to force vaccinate and trying to force microchipping, which that's the mark of the beast, upon the people. And the scripture says you're going to come down with great wrath because you know your time is up. You know that you are at the last little drops of sand in the hourglass. And you're doing all of this because you know our Lord is coming and you're about to be destroyed and put into slavery. And your kingdom's at an end. The prophets already saw you. The prophets saw you hurt the earth with violence and the people and force microchipping people and putting people to death. They already saw you sparing none like madmen. Madmen sparing none. They already saw you doing that, man. And they also all saw the deliverance of the elect by our Lord and Savior, Yahushua, which is the stone that had broke the statue's feet, that was mixed with clay and iron, that broke the statue's feet, and that lion that roared up against the eagle. They all saw Yahusha coming to deliver the elect from your hurtful and wicked hands. You devils will continue to be exposed, and just know the prophecy is that you are at the end. You are going down. I'm giving all praises to Yahweh Bashim Yahusha Bashim Rakah Kodash. I'm saying double honors to our apostles and elders here at Great Millstone.